Hey, Neurosight, what's going on, man? Nice. Hey, Willie, what's going on? Hey, man. Hey Nevin, what's up? Drifter, what's up, man? Death metal. I want to have this in the center, but I don't think it really matters once they use that hacker device. That's what I'm talking about. Raptor, are you telling me you now know that? Is that what you're telling me? Is that what you're telling me, sir? Hey, what's up, man? Nice park job. So I noticed that I completely forgot about the shield. I like took the shield out when I was building before, and I never remembered to like put it somewhere else. So, now we don't have a place for the shield. Well, we do. We kind of do, which is probably up here. So let's check that out. I hate you, shield. No radiation. Probably do some glass or something. We do better. So, feel like we can do better with that. Yeah, exactly. It's ridiculous. It needs to have a smaller one. I agree. Took it down there. Yeah, I probably need to start separating shit. Separating our stuff a little bit there. That's probably what we need to do. Well, it's only one way to learn, man. That's to build.
We'll
Man, what's going on, Bitdragon? How you doing? I just realized I was muted the whole time I was responding to Raptor. I'm just saying to, you know, just keep building stuff, man. Just keep playing with the blocks. Once you understand the blocks and how to use them, you'll kind of start drawing with them in your head, and then you'll be able to build a lot better. But, like, right now, like, you probably have an idea as to what you want, but you don't know how to translate that into blocks, because you don't really know what blocks are available and all that kind of stuff. Once you do, then, you know, a lot easier. Still need a place for the repair station too. I kind of need like a little QRF area. Should really be up here too. Right, how do you get up here? I just realized I have no way to get up here. I haven't done the elevator yet. I think I've been building too many things. I swear I did an elevator. Oh, it's right here. No, I did do an elevator. For the... This goes out. Oh, that's weird. Oh, well, I do have a block here. Yeah, thin ventilator's pretty badass. Yeah, there you go. Get there. You will get there, sir. Definitely not afraid to take on a challenge, so that's all you really need, man. New curves. Lighting looks weird. Oh, that's a problem. Is there a block for that? I'm laughing. There might be a block for that. There damn well should be. And then there was. changing stuff all over the place here. Yeah, you can't ever commit to anything. Always gotta be willing to change it up. Let's move this over one. So I got a question, is 4 full cargo systems enough for a starter base? Yeah, absolutely. So 4 cargo systems is plenty. I think that's enough for endgame. But that's just me. I don't ever see why you need that much of anything. It means you're either not using it, you're not gonna use it, or you're not building enough stuff, or whatever. Yeah, I just don't see the need to store that much stuff. For me, a starter base, you know, this one has, you know, I'll need to expand this a little bit. I'd like to get to 32, so I still gotta play with that. But you really need 2 big systems. And then boxes for output. So, like, this would be like my main ore input, right, for processing. And then it would go to the furnace, it would go to the deconstructor, it would go wherever, right? It's the input. So, you know, I'm gonna, you know, in this base, I'll have a deconstructor, I'll have a furnace, I'll have 2 advanced constructors, small constructors. They can all point to this input. So what's going to happen is if I have a furnace in here, it's going to point to this as input and output. So it's automatically going to grab the ore, and it's going to put the ingots back in. So now those ingots can be used for the advanced constructors. The same with the deconstructor. Now you could do it 2 ways. You could have this secondary box as like your deconstructor, because the deconstructor stuff is huge. It's your warp drive. It's the stuff that's a lot of volume, right? So you'll put those in there, and then they'll process out, and then the parts can go into the... Your output never has to be that big, because if you're crafting something, chances are you're going to use it. It's going to go somewhere else. It's not going to remain in a box. So, yeah, you never need like a big output. Now, if you're mass producing like stuff, you know, you have plenty of boxes that you can, you know, fit those things in. That's what these are for. So, yeah. You just take a little bit less space. So you don't need like a 320K output and a 320K input. You know, multiple input, that's fine, you know, if you're doing like a more complex system. But for me, I just need a really big input, and I can process and I can do everything, and all that input can go into where I would use it for construction. Everything else is kind of small stuff, you know. So that's why I have 2 here. I have basically 1 for input. I have a big one for like deconstruction and just overflow parts. Let's say you find a CV warp drive and you don't have a CV yet. Probably want to keep that warp drive so that you can use it later on, so you don't destruct it, so you have a place to store it there, like a secondary, large area to store it. Four to me is a bit overkill, if I'm being honest. So I've given myself an area to put some URF here. Yeah, BitDragon, definitely. How long since you've been gone? Okay, copy. Yeah, man. 10's good. A lot of cool stuff, man, I gotta say. There's a lot to come, man. They took their time with it. I'm really happy they did. A lot of really cool stuff. Yeah. I haven't heard any real complaints, to be honest. I mean, everybody seems to be pretty happy about it all. That's a good sign. I don't know. I think he said he was pretty much done with it, right? Last I heard was he was done with the game and impressed with what happened at night. I mean, you know, I think that the game itself has gotten a little bit more, engineering kind of. I mean, not really. It's still really dumbed down. The whole logistics system is very simplistic and figure out. But I think people just weren't open to that big of a change, and it scared away some of the people that weren't kind of design minded, more user minded, and everything. I see. So. That's just my take on it. You know, he wasn't a builder. He wasn't somebody that kind of understood that aspect of the game. So I think because of that, he kind of couldn't adapt. All right, let's do a price check here. Let's take the stuff that sense to it. Yeah, so pretty nice and spaced out, and that's kind of what I'm going for. The neodymium and the satium are for the rocket turrets. I don't want to I didn't want to do all minigun turrets. I guess I could have. I didn't really want to. I wanted people to have those rockets. For force. Defense and assault mode. Plenty of coverage, plenty of 360 coverage all the way around. I don't see anything really kind of getting through this, to be honest. Just the rockets alone, would devastate anything coming from really any direction, on ground or on surface, on sky. Yeah, being such a small footprint as Yeah, SVs are useless. That's why I don't really build them, because I don't see a need for them. I built this as an ode to the original Switchblade, but I didn't. Otherwise, I wouldn't have really built it. I just don't see the point. I mean, it's fun from an RP sense to get into an SV and, fly around, but there's no use. There's really no use for it. It doesn't. And now with the cargo, there's really no use for it. Because in order to build an SV that can carry anything, my God, it's got to be huge. Even the cargo blade, it's just not a viable solution. You might as well make the CV, CV can carry stuff, and gotta make an SV almost big enough as a CV to carry anything, Yeah, so I really hope they figure that out, because don't get me wrong, I'd love to fly SVs. I'd love to build them. There was a nice, a really cool function to it. There's some really cool SVs on the workshop that I fell in love with early. The Taurus being one of them. If you ever get a chance to look at the Taurus on the workshop, just beautiful, just amazing craftsmanship, really cool role play. But just really no use to it. Use for it. A lot of people like to, fly these and attack POIs, and I made this thing to do just that, and from what people tell me, it does a good job. But yeah, right, we need to jazz up the outside a bit here. Transition from turret could be kind of. Oh, you know what? Well, before we forget, let's finish the inside, because there's no bed. Beds are a thing now, so we need to have some kind of a room. I don't know if that's let's see here. Well, you know what we should do first is expand this cargo. These are cargo extensions going all the way across, right? Now, well, I'll do the texture test here. So, can't any further. Oh, we kind of can, can't we? I can't. It's the beauty of a base. I don't have to worry about weight distribution or anything. Is this a 240? Oh yeah, no, yeah. Is I have the block. No, it's not there. Yeah, I've done a couple big HVs for sure. That's for 32,000 cargo. I never finished it though, but it's a 432,000. Bidirectional piloting. Multi-turrets and stuff. It's freaking, but you gotta have this much freaking thrust on it to move it when it's full. Look at that. That's what's required just to move this thing with cargo. It's just crazy.